master equation, energy equation for control volume. But the pathway is we have to go through control mass. Okay. So let's go there then. Okay, so first of all, mass balance, that is straightforward. Either you can apply it across control volume, or you can simply say that, yeah, so this is basically mass balance across CV. Across CV. So which is nothing but the mass across over this CV at time t plus dt should be equal to what it was at time t, the mass of this control volume, mass inside the control volume, how much came in time dt, and how much goes out in time dt. That will give you the new mass of this control volume at time t plus dt. So mass balance is simple across control volume. It's very simple. Okay. Is it clear, Sraman, this mass balance?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so what you have, what came in? Oh, sorry. No one is it right? Are you sure? There is no mistake. And there is a typo. There's a minus. Yes, it's true. So when I was typing, so this is minus. Okay. So just correct it. So that is mass balance across the U. Very simple. That whatever you have at the present time at t plus dt, that is what was you have in this over this control volume at time t, how much came in, how much went out. Okay. Then our system is always control mass, because we can apply this first law to a control mass, which we are calling a system. Okay. So system envelope is changing with time, no doubt. So system envelope changes with time. In our case, why there is a question mark? Because that's what I'm calling system. Control is my control mass is my system. Okay, great. So this is fine up to this point. And I have written specifically here, as you can see, underlined, that first law is applicable to a fixed set of particles, a fixed mass, which you know as control mass. So it's written here. Okay. Fundamentally, I mean to say fundamentally. We will finally develop an expression which is valid for control volume, but that is not fundamental. That you derive from fundamental principles. Fundamentally. Great. Let's go to then here. Okay. Now we will write down energy balance for control mass. Remember, I am right, or for system. So in order to avoid any confusion, I will write control mass is my system. Okay, so that's why in place of control mass, I will always use now system. So from first law, what we know that Q given to system, right? Then work done by system is equal to delta E of system, right? So Rahul Nath, is it right? You agree up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Rahul, then tell me what will be delta E system in this process. So what is our system, by the way? Rahul, what is your system?
Yes, sir.
What is our system?
So the control mass.
Yes. So it means delta E system means E system
at time t plus t,
right? Minus E system at t. So yes. For everyone, see carefully. You have to write it very carefully. I am saying system. So E system at t plus dt minus E system at t. Because I am control mass is my system. Perfect.
Yes.
Yes. Now, if we are talking, Rahul, in terms of rate, I can write Q2 system is Q dot dt. Now, I have removed this two system. So, that is understood. You agree that if I talk in terms of rate, then Q total Q is Q dot dt in time dt, right?
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay.
And now, we will see work. So, I'll interact with Raman and Rahul. So, let's talk about work. So, work by system. Now, if you'll see, there are two components of work which we can think of in such flow system. One is
soft
work. Okay. So, soft work we discussed. What is the convention of soft work? It's a convention. One can always argue why this convention. I mean, it's a matter of, it's not a matter of discussion. It's just a matter of convention. So, W soft. This word soft is always, remember, for by system. There should not be any confusion. Conventionally, by system. Okay, so if fluid is running a turbine or any fan, okay, then W soft is going to be positive.
Positive.
Yeah, and if you are using pump or some rotator, a steerer,
then it's negative.
Yeah, then it's negative. Okay. W soft is negative. Okay. Great. So you can note it down because I will remove it from here. So W soft is clear. I am removing it because I need this space. Yes? Any doubt? Anyone?
Sir, in the first line, why we are just considering Q2 system? What if the heat is removed from the system?
So then its sign will be negative. Simple. I am saying by convention, I will say it's two system. You have to follow one convention, that either two system or by. So conventionally in first law, how we define it? Q2 system, W by system, right? Bhavna?
Oh, yes, sir.
If it is a heat is going out from the system, its sign will be negative. Simple. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. So this is the actual first law. Q2 system minus W by system is equal to delta E system. Generally, we don't write 2 by. We write Q minus W is delta E. But this is the more precise mathematical expression. Okay. Fine. So Rahul, this soft work is clear. Right? Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's come back to, there is another work. If you see the system carefully, at inlet and outlet, if we'll go to, so at inlet, let's say this is my fixed mass is at time t. Sorry. At time t, this is my system, which is controlled. Okay, so what is happening to this? The outside fluid is applying a pressure, right, Rahul?
Yes, sir.
Which we are saying as P inlet. Okay.
Yep.
Fine. And then due to this pressure, this fluid later on at later time will come here. You agree? This layer, red layer. Red part of envelope will come here. You agree?
Yes, sir.
So how much work has been done by this inlet pressure?
The pressure into the change in volume. That
change
is
in
the
volume. Fine. So change in volume, let's say delta V, right?
Okay.
Pi delta V, I can write simply this way, that is specific volume at inlet. Right?
Minus specific volume.
How much mass has been entered? Isn't it?
Okay, sir.
Or you can go through force into displacement. See, delta V as ADX also. That is also fine. Whatever you want. See, I can write delta V as ADX also. If you think it's more fundamental. A at inlet into let's say DS. Or delta S, whatever you want to say. Both are fine. Okay. So we can see from both ways. Right? Okay.
Yes.
So, rather than DMI, we can say delta MI, delta MI, or DMI is also fine. And what is DMI? DMI is nothing but in terms of time. Anyone? Rahul, you tell me. It's nothing but PI, VI, MI dot DT, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is, and same, if you go through this part also, you'll get the same thing. I'm not going here. Okay. So work done by the external fluid on this control, on the inlet of this control mass is what? Pi, Vi, Mi dot
Id.
Right? Okay. So if I say work done by the system on, because we always talk in terms of by the system. So what we have to do, Rahul? We have to put a
negative
sign. Okay. So first I have written word PV work by system. Okay. And then see here that now I have decoupled it here. So work I have written this way. W in terms of rate, of course. So rate of work done, PV work by system will be equal to minus sign bracketed work PV on system at inlet and work PV on system at outlet. Is it fine, Rahul?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it's straightforward. So this component we already found. So this is with a minus sign outside. We are saying work the PV on system. So what is this, Rahul? This quantity? Tell me this quantity. W this dot PV work, right?
Yes, this is the
on system, that's on system, right? On system by external fluid, right? Because we haven't put minus sign yet. So this is here.
Yes.
Pi specific volume Vi Mi dot
Mi dot dt.
Okay, right. Plus. Now we'll see whether plus or minus. Okay. Right now put plus. Now let's go to outlet. Huh? So what will happen at later time? The way you we saw here the green boundary, this red boundary will be pushed here, right?
Yes.
And that's how we'll constitute our new envelope. So let's talk about the PV work here. Okay. So here, if you'll write here work done at this point. Huh? Let's write down. So this will be P exit, V exit, ME dot DT. Okay. Now if I say PV work on system. So tell me, Rahul, or Sraman, you tell me that in this case, which one is actually working? The fluid or the external? The fluid inside our envelope or fluid outside our envelope?
What inside.
Inside. It means this time work done our by system is positive, right?
Yes.
So it means work done on system should be negative because I have expressed everything in terms of on system from by to on. So what I should put here rather than plus? A minus, right? Minus P V M E dot D T. So this way now we know W dot P V work by system. What I did for simplicity, by system I converted it into on system two component. I wrote the expression and now I know my W dot P V work by system, which is simply if we'll open this bracket, it comes out to be P specific volume at exit M E dot D T. Minus Pi Vi Mi dot Dt. Okay. So now this also we know. Great. Acha, few very important points before we move, because now we know all terms in this expression. Before we move, tell me that so here probably you overlooked few things, and let me discuss those things. Huh? Let me save this first, otherwise I'll forget, and I'll save derivation energy balance. Save. Now tell me that let me open a new page. So what I was going to ask, I forgot. Yes, fine. Now I remember. Okay. So Sraman, you can try what I'm going to ask. Okay. So this is, let's say, cross-sectional, a line, cutting this inlet, okay, a vertical line. Fine, Sraman? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And then let's say we have these flow lines. So this, what do you think? Velocity, what we should use? V is for a specific volume, capital V, let's say. So this, because for a volume, I will use this V cut. This velocity, or say it velocity now. So velocity is perpendicular to cross-sectional area?
Yes.
Right. Okay. Both at inlets and outlets. If that is not the case, let's say, rather than this, if we have such kind of cross-section, then, Sraman, what you will do?
V dot A.
So basically, we have to take the dot product, right? So if you are using this, the master equation which we are going to derive, remember by default, you are assuming, and which is the real scenario in most of the application, that flow is perpendicular to cross-sectional area at inlet and outlet. That assumption is there. Okay, Sraman, does it make sense? So whenever you will use the energy equation which we are going to achieve finally, that is only valid when, tell me what I should write, cross-section, Sraman.
Cross-section is perpendicular to the velocity vector.
At where?
At the point of inlet and outlet.
Yes, at inlet and outlet. That is one assumption. Otherwise, you have to take this cost component. That is point number one. Secondly, let's see who can answer. So, Rohit Sutradhar, you can hear me? Rohit. Music sunne. Pata karo music sunne gaya hai. Mujhe batana. Okay. So. Yeah, Bhavna, you tell me then. A second question which I'm going to ask. So, if you consider any point near the wall, pipe has a wall or control volume has a wall, whatever flow device this is. So near the wall, let's say this is wall and these are fluid molecules. Let's say some fluid domain. So this wall will exert what kind of forces here on this wall? If a fluid molecule adhere to the wall, what force it will apply? What are the forces you think it can apply to that fluid domain, the wall?
Sir, like the, if we consider the layer just below the wall, it will
just
have...
below, like adhere to it, just in the vicinity of, like just next to the wall, you can say.
That will have zero velocity and then hence there will
very
be
good.
A...
Very no work done. So even if there is force, one is normal force by wall and another is shear force, right? Tangentially. There is a tangential force also between the fluid and the wall. Let's say it's shear force. Even these forces exist, what we assume, you said, Bhavna, that since fluid particle velocity is zero, what we know it in more chemical engineering point of view, what we know this condition, what is the name of this condition?
No slip condition,
very good. So due to this no slip condition, the velocity of fluid molecules near wall, we assume it is zero. And since velocity is zero, except inlet at outlets, we are assuming there is no work done. If your fluid will slip, there will work done. But we are assuming that there is no slip. Okay. So there is no slip. So work done near boundaries, except inlet and outlet is zero. And that's why we only considered work at inlet and outlet. Okay, that is point number one. Now, second point. This probably Sneh can try. So we are saying, Sneh, that if you consider, let's say, fluid or wall or fluid, let's say two fluid layers. This is one fluid layer and this is another fluid layer. So, or it can be like this also, one fluid. You can draw it whatever in whatever way you want. So, one, between two fluid layers, what forces you expect, Sneh? I expect force. Normal force?
There will be shear forces. But
why not normal?
For molecules, like it will be, yeah.
No, on an average, don't you think there will be normal force also, which we know as pressure?
Yes, sir.
That's why one liquid pushes another liquid, na, in a pipe.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So there is normal force also, there is shear force also. Now you think at inlet carefully that we consider the work done by the pressure at inlet and outlet. That is normal force kind of, right?
Yes, sir.
What about shear forces? Acha, tell me here, let's you can answer it. I know I have to just make that picture very clear to you and then you see you can answer. Let's say one fluid layer is this. Can you see, Sneh? Okay.
Yes, sir.
And what is the direction of the velocity? This way.
Right? Open.
Yeah. And another fluid layer is like this. And of course, this fluid layer will also move this way. So due to pressure force or that normal component of the force, the light green layer will push the blue layer, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, between these two, there is shear force also. Of course, no doubt. There is shear force also. There may be. But since this shear force, F shear, is perpendicular to velocity, right?
Yes, sir.
So, the work done by shear force is?
Zero.
So, at inlet and at outlet also, work done by shear force is zero. And that's why, if you see my original derivation, the work done, this PV work, shear work, whatever, the only term which survive is this. So this way now we are completely convinced that the only work, PV work is this, which we have written. Okay, great. So this is fine. I'll again, but save button. Why it asks me every time? Oh, is it automatically say, acha, so page wise it is getting saved, correct? Nice. Great. So now let's go to another agenda. So this is fine. We written everything. Great. Now let's talk about, so let's be on this slide itself. And then now let's talk about E system at T. So E system at T is anyone? Aaj anyone mein koi nahi bol raha hai. E system. Samira, you'd want to try. What is E system at T? It's written there. If you think you understand, then tell us. Because we have covered Q dot is fine. It's very simple. Heat given to the system at what rate? Work done, we decoupled. Now we know the work components. Now we are interested in this right hand side. So we have to write down what these terms are. So Samira, what is this E system at T? What is our system, Samira?
So it is written, but I'm not able to understand.
Yeah. So okay. Someone else can try. Anyone wants to try?
So like E system can be the like
first of all, what is E system? It's a control mass. Okay. Remember.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that we will. So that we can write E control volume at T. Right. And what we have to add in this? What we are leaving?
Extra mass.
Extra mass. Yeah. So this one. Okay. So CV is the that original. So CV is that original black line, black dashed line. So my CV, if I will say formal CV, is this. I want a energy equation across this gray line. This is my CV, original CV. So if I want to, but my system is system envelope is changing. So if I want to write E system at T, then I have to write E CV at T plus whatever I have left this thing. So MI dot EI DT. Now can who was interacting with me? Sneh or who was I'm trying to answer?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So Sneh, what is this E? It's written here. Can you guess?
So it is like sum of internal energy, kinetic energy, and potential energy,
gravitational. Specific, because mass is not there, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so it's a specific. Specific energy, that's all. Right? Which contains specific internal energy, specific kinetic energy, and specific gravitational potential energy. And if in some systems exist nuclear energy, chemical energy, that also you can add. So this is done, E system at T. Then we need this second term, E system at T plus DT. What it will be, Sneh? Again, same thing?
Yes, sir.
Now it will be ECV at T plus DT. So my control volume envelope is same, but its energy has changed. That's what will happen, right? That is gray area, its energy will change with time, right? My original control volume, right?
Yes, sir.
So my E system at T plus DT, I can write E, this gray control volume at T plus DT, plus what I am leaving from control, like what is my new control envelope? This part I have to include, right? Because we are following fixed set of particles. Now my envelope is that green envelope. So apart from this control volume, whatever energy property I have at T plus DT, I have to include this part, right, Sneh? You agree?
Yes, sir.
So I have included that. ME dot exit, specific energy at exit, DT. Okay. Because MI dot DT will give you the how much mass has been exit. And then you have to multiply it with specific energy. Okay. See, specific energy is nothing but energy per unit mass. Okay. So you have to multiply it with total mass. So here at inlet, how much mass we were leaving? This one? This is nothing but what? If I'll ask, so basically this is nothing but, you see it here, this is nothing but EI into DMI at inlet. Simple. Energy per unit mass at inlet multiplied by how much mass is getting in. And DMI, I can always write MI dot DT. Okay. So in now we express everything in terms of specific quantities. That's why I said specific energy. Same is true for here also. This is nothing but EE. So
like this line, it should be negative, no? The mass is exiting.
No. Listen, see, you are trying to calculate energy, right, Sneh?
Yes,
energy of what?
Of my system.
So it means that you have to first find out where is my new envelope at time t plus dt, right? You agree?
Yes,
so what
yes.
is our new envelope? Green envelope, right?
Yes, sir.
And green envelope consists of this gray original control volume plus something extra. You want the energy of this envelope, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you have to add the energies, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there is no sign confusion. Good. Great. So now we have written everything. You see, we know Q dot, we know shaft work, we know E system at T plus DT, we know E system at T. Let's write down everything at one place. Okay. And then I'll give you full time to like whatever small doubts you have on this. And okay. So here, so I have written down that thing here for you. So this is Q dot DT. Then work done, we had two components, this one. Okay. And then this term is what? Nothing but just for your understanding, E system at T plus dt. And then this term is nothing but E system at T. Okay. Now put the various components. So this is Q dot dt. Then this is shaft work and PV work by system. If you remember PV work by system, we already found this. Okay. Then we know these values also, EE and EI. Okay. So what I have done, that I have done this mathematics, and I have brought these two terms, this and this, on the left hand side. Okay. So now let's try to put everything here and let's see what we get. Right. So I'll write for you Q dot. So first of all, we take dt common and then we put it on the right hand side. So I'm writing here right hand side. It will be ECV T plus dt minus ECV at T. Achha, can you notice that how we moved from control mass to control volume? Right. We started from E system. And finally, we broke it in such a way that now we are able to write here CV. Are you getting it, Bhavna? What I'm trying to say? That ultimately now we have something in terms of CV through this path, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's why I meant to say that you may think that fundamental principles are applicable to both control mass and control volume, but that is not the case. You derived something which is means the derived form may be valid, but fundamentally no. Okay, so I have taken out dt common and I have took it on the right hand side. Now here we have q dot minus w dot. Now I will not write soft work, I will only write subscript s. Okay, so for this I will write w dot s, soft work, and then minus of w dot pv work by system. Okay, so this should be, I hope there is no mistake of sign. So what we got, by the way, in previous pages, work done by system, just check. I think it should be fine. So this is minus, and then again minus of work done by system, and work done by system, it should be, let's see here also, it's written. I just want to check there is no mistake. So this is work done by system, P sign is positive. Take it. Okay, so this is nothing but minus P V. You guys can also check later on if there is any mistake of sign. DT we have already removed on the right hand side. Minus plus PI VI MI dot. Okay, so work done is done. Then we have these two terms, minus M dot E plus M dot I EI is equal to this. Okay. Now EI, replace this EI with whatever we have. Or in fact, this we can do later. First, try to arrange it. So now I am arranging it this way. Q dot minus WS dot. Okay. And then, so let's write it. What is E and EI? So let's write it. Yes, Bhavna, can you help me? What is EE? Yes, UE, right? Plus, let's say velocity is VE square by 2 plus GJD. Agree? Fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and then plus MI dot UI plus VI square by 2 plus ZZI. Now I will write it in a special fashion from here to here. Now what I'm going to do, Q dot minus WS, and then I will write it plus, I will take MI dot common. So what terms I'm using, I'll just mark it for your for the clear. So I'm taking mi dot common. So this term I'm writing here, pi vi, then this term ui plus sign, that's all. Okay, I know. Then plus which term I am taking, this term and this term also. So vi square by 2 plus gz I. Similarly, minus m dot exit, and then I am taking this term and this whole thing. So ue plus pv plus v square by 2 plus gzd. That's it. That should be equal to what is this thing? Of course, this time is very tending to zero. So in that limit, what it is? DE of CV. D of CV, right? And what we know from our definition of enthalpy? UI plus PIV is nothing but HI. And this is nothing but HE. And then we got this master equation. That's all. Remember the assumption always. This is only valid when you are saying at inlet and outlet, your flow is perpendicular to cross section. And you assume no slip condition at the wall. Under these two conditions, it is valid. Of course, other conditions are there, incompressible fluid and all such stuffs are there. Your fluid is not compressible. Okay. Although I don't think that will matter. No, that will matter, because when you say pressure volume work, if your fluid is compressible, then it becomes more complex. Okay. So, but two important major assumptions which we always remember while using this. Let's open a press page. So now we know that this is our master equation. So, but we should always remember, and you can go to this slide in order to write key points. Okay. What we should remember is that this is our master equation. What we should remember is that this is, we should apply only when we are saying that flow, this velocity is perpendicular to cross section. This is cross section. Okay. And this is flow. This should be perpendicular to cross section. And another assumption what we are saying is that no slip condition at all. No slip conditions at inner boundary of okay. Although there are again more assumptions, but I think from thermodynamics point of view, that is not important. That is important from fluid mechanics point of view. So for example, just you know, now if you want to dig it, you see that there are so many assumptions which generally we don't care. Let's say if this is the inlet, okay, if this is the inlet, and if it is let's say it has it is a circular inlet, like circular cross section, then what kind of velocity profile we expect? Anyone? Shravan?
Parabolic.
Parabolic, right? Parabolic. But in reality, you have taken only one velocity, Vi. So this is nothing but average velocity. Okay? So if someone has profile, then he has to first find out average velocity. So Vi, if you want to find out, let's say this is average one, then you have to do this Vi dA by A at inlet. You got the point? If you go into the assumption, there are many assumptions in this simple derivation. But from a thermodynamics point of view, we are mainly concerned about rough numbers. We don't want to be very precise. Remember, we are engineers. We are not scientists. So that should be our main purpose, to solve a problem, not to complicate it. Okay. Great. So I think now it makes sense that now we have this final energy equation. Of course, it will take you also some revision to take in this whole discussion. So take your time. I will quickly show you the application of this this master equation. And then tomorrow again, we will discuss something very interesting, the various equipment and very important process or equipment that is throttling device, which is extensively used in our household, in industry, whether you are in your fridge or ice cream, wherever you need chilling, I mean, cold environment, throttling is very important. And the science of throttling, the molecular interpretation, it's really very insightful. We will like it. So that we'll discuss tomorrow. That is the part of this, the application of this energy balance, which we have just seen. Okay. So quickly in 2 minutes, just one application and then you can leave. Okay. So, So what you see here, one such simple device is called nozzle. And what is the purpose of nozzle? That its mouth is a bit narrow as compared, means outlet is narrower as compared to inlet. And so there is a gradual decrease in cross-section area. If you make the walls adiabatic, which is generally the case, even if you don't make the walls adiabatic, this process happens very fast. So the heat changes you can ignore. Either you make the walls adiabatic or you can ignore Q, because this process is very fast in nozzle. You have seen nozzles, I think. If not, then try to find out how nozzle looks like. See YouTube videos. I am sure you have seen it. So in nozzle, how this principle works. So if you'll go to our original principle. So let's say here. Sneh, you help me. Tell me. Sorry. So tell me, so we are talking about steady state process, first of all. We'll mostly deal with steady state, but few problems I'm going to cover on unsteady state also. So generally devices, we assume they are work at steady state, which is not the case actually. It takes some time to reach to steady state. So in steady state, what will be this term, Sneh, d by dt? Zero.
Steady state.
Okay. Zero. Fine. Since it's a nozzle, do you think there is any difference in elevation? Significant difference? This Zi and
Zd? No. Significant? No. No.
Remove this. Okay. Fine. Great. Do you think there is any soft work? It's a simple nozzle. Air is passing through it. No fan. So this is also gone. We left with what? Okay. Then. If you apply the mass balance, there is no doubt that mi dot has to be equal to me dot, right? If you are talking about steady state, there is no mass accumulation. So dm by dt has to be zero. So it means, so here we have zero and we have mi and me dot, both are equal. So you can take it common. This will also vanish. What we left with? Hi plus vi square by 2 is equal to, why I have cut this he. He is there. He, this will go. He plus V. This is the equation of nozzle in terms of enthalpy and kinetic energy. Simple. Okay, that's what I have written here. You'll see. And this equation is valid for both nozzle and diffuser. Diffuser is just work in a reverse fashion. You open a pipe from a narrow to a wider zone. Okay, and then velocity decreases. So this is the equation of nozzle or diffuser. We'll solve some problem. Then you can apply it simply for heat exchanger. So Bhavna, can you guess which term will survive for this heat exchanger? Let me go there on the slide, on this balance. In fact, what I can do, Control C, Control V. If you apply a heat exchanger at steady state, let's say, okay.
So dE by dt term will go to zero.
But steady state, this gone. Okay, perfect. For heat exchanger, huh? What no else? No elevation, of course. Everything at the same level, gone.
So Z term gone.
And what about Q dot?
Q dot, it should be there.
No. Heat exchanger, as a combined, it's a system. They are exchanging heat among each other, right? There is a hot pipe, there is a cold pipe.
Q dot also zero.
Yeah, exactly, because they are exchanging heat within the system. So Q dot is also zero. Okay. What about velocities? So we say that these pipes, since cross-section area is uniform, so Vi and V are same, right? This applies this volume conservation. Okay. or they are insignificant, you can say, not very high. That is also one logic. So generally we ignore this v and vi. So we left with only m dot I hi is equal to m dot e. This is the master equation for heat exchanger. What Bhavna, if you have multiple inlet and outlets for heat exchanger, put summation, right? That's all. Okay. Clear, Bhavna?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we see we solved this energy equation for two cases, three cases: nozzle, diffuser, heat exchanger. Tomorrow when we'll meet, we'll do a very important process, a very practical application from a practical application perspective. Very important. That is throttling process. Okay. Thank you guys for your time. And I will upload, Swabik will upload solution of assignment 2 after contacting Sneh. Okay. Just he will correct his. I will also go through it, whether to make sure he hasn't made any mistake. And Amar, are you there? Amar Nath Mehta?
Yes, sir.
Just now, since you are clear about this, steam based problem, you try to call assignment 3 and we'll upload it. Okay.
Yes, sir. Great.
Thank you, guys. Thanks to all.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, you can leave for another class. Don't worry.
Sir, just a small question. If there are multiple inlet and outlets, so can we? So how do we modify the master equation? Do we put a summation there?
Yeah, rather than one inlet, you have to add more and more terms, right? Even in our this energy balance also in master equation, you can put a summation at that inlet at here. Just a moment, I stopped sharing. See, we have solved it for one inlet and outlet, but if you go for more generic case. If you go for here itself, if you go for more generic case, if you have multiple inlet and outlets, then we have summation here also and here also. Okay. Means you have to calculate these terms at all inlets and this term at all outlets. Okay.
Okay, sir. Understood.
Simple. Yes, Amar. So, in case you feel any confusion, you can contact me on Teams.
Sir, I will mail you, sir, all the.
Don't email me. You always put it on Teams chat. There is a option for dropping and to do an attachment. Okay, not on my email box is full. I have it. So, if you send anything very large size, it will not come to me.
Okay. Sir, but I have a little bit confusion on question number 4, sir.
So you write it. Not here. You write here on the chat box. Okay.
Okay.
If it is too much, if it's difficult to write, you can give me a call. Message me, sir. Call me. You know my number, right?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Fine. Chalo. Thank you. Mm-hmm.